Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand the design of a basic computer with common bus system. So we're going to take, this is the design of the basic computer, and this computer is a very basic computer, which means that the operations that are performed on this computer are very simple. In order to have better understanding of how a computer works, we have taken this basic computer. The computers that are available these days are very complex, which means the operations that are performed by that computer are very complex operations are performed by the latest the computers that we are going to use these days. And this is a very simple computer where the simple operations are performed. Why we have taken this simple computer is in order to have the better understanding of how a computer works, we have taken this simple basic computer. In this class, we will try to, and this computer is connected to the common bus. In this class, we will try to understand what are the different components that are available and how the interconnections between those components is done. That we will try to understand in this class. Now, coming to this diagram, so this is the design of the basic computer, and this basic computer consists of 8 resistors. See here, the resistors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It consists of 8 resistors and one memory unit. So it is what we call it as a RAM. Memory unit means it is not hard disk, it is RAM, random access memory. Along with this eight resistors, it is having a memory unit and one bus unit. So the discussion about common bus system, the discussion about the common bus system, where the resistors are interconnected, where the resistors are interconnected, the interconnections of the resistor for the transfer of data from one resistor to another resistor has already been done in our previous videos. Without understanding that concept, it is very difficult for you to understand how the transfer between the resistors is happening. So our suggestion is to please watch that video and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now, the components that are available in this basic computer are 8 resistors and one memory unit, and this is what we call it as bus system. And the other component is adder, so ALU, adder and logic, so arithmetic logic unit, we call it as here adder and logic unit. The only arithmetic operation that we are going to perform on this ALU is adding. So it is called as adder and logic unit, one flip flop. So extra flip flop is provided. So why these flip flops are provided, that we will try to understand in our later classes. So and we are also provided with a control system, so which is not provided in this diagram. Another component called control system will be there, where the control signals will be generated for the specific operations. So we will try to understand how those control signals will get generated and how the design of that control system will be in our later classes. Right now we have 8 resistors, one control unit, one memory unit, one bus system and one adder and logic unit. So how these components are interconnected? So here every resistor, some of the resistors are provided with some numbers. So what are those numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this is 7. So why these numbers are provided? So in order to transfer the data from one resistor to another resistor, these selection bits will get selected. So based upon the selection that we have done, the data of that resistor will be transferred onto the bus, and the output of each and every resistor is connected. The output of some of the resistors is connected to the bus, and this bus is the data. This is a 16-bit common bus. 16 lines will be there, and the lines of this common bus are connected to the inputs of the resistors. Here the input of this resistor is connected to this, the input of this resistor is connected, the input of this resistor is connected to the bus, And similarly, the inputs of the some of the resistors are connected to the bus, and the outputs of the some of the resistors are connected to the common bus. So what does that mean is, whenever we want to, for example, if we want to transfer the data from this resistor by name DR, so there is a resistor by name DR. So what this DR means, that we will try to understand later. Let's assume that there is a resistor called DR and there is a resistor called TR. Here we have another resistor called TR. So this is TR and this is DR. Now we want to transfer the content of DR to TR. So this is a TR. Now we want to transfer the content of DR into TR. So how the transfer will happen? So here the number that is provided for DR is 3. The number that is provided for DR is 3. And the number that is provided for TR is 6. Okay. So now we are going to select. We are going to the select inputs of the common bus is provided with the binary equivalent of DR. What is the binary equivalent of 3? Decimal number 3. Which is 011. So S0 is provided, S1 is provided, and S0 is provided with 110. Whenever 110 is provided to this select lines, the content of this DR will be transferred onto this common bus. So this resistor is a 16-bit resistor, and the content of this DR will be transferred onto this common bus. Now the content of DR is now available on this common bus, which means every resistor is provided with its with the content of this DR. But will they get inserted? Will they get loaded onto the resistor? No. So when they will get loaded is whenever the load input of the resistor will get activated, then only the content will be transferred through the input to the resistors. So the control system, what the control system will do is, whenever the content is on the common bus and the load inputs here, each and every resistor is provided with independent inputs. Load INR clear. INR means increment. Clear means clear the entire content of that particular resistor. So these are the independent controls that are provided. So whenever the load input of this TR resistor will get activated, then only the content will get transferred into this resistor. See here, this point is very important to understand. So the control system will generate a signal. So how that control system is going to generate the signal, that we are going to understand in our later classes. Right now, assume that a signal has been generated and this load has been activated, so that the content that is present on the common bus will get transferred onto this TR. This is also a 16-bit resistor. So this is how the transfer among the resistors will happen. So this is how the resistors and the memory unit. See, the memory unit is also connected to the output of the output of this memory unit is connected to the bus, and the memory unit is connected to the inputs of this common bus. So the input of this memory unit is provided with the common bus interconnections. Okay. So now it is provided with write and read inputs. Whenever the write will get activated, the input, the data on this will get stored onto this memory, and whenever the read will get activated, this will get the content on this memory unit will be transferred onto the bus. Okay, this is address, this is what we call it as address register. The output of this address register is connected to this memory unit. And apart from that, we have adder and logic unit, and the output of this data register is connected to adder and logic unit, and also the output of this register is connected to this adder and logic unit, and also the INPR. So these are very small resistors. These are 8-bit resistors. This is input resistor and output resistor. So the input of this input of this input resistor is connected to this ADR. So ALU in the sense adder and logic unit. Okay, so these are the connections, these are the interconnections between the components of the basic computer. Hope you got the clarity on this concept, and this concept is very, very important to understand. So this diagram is very important to understand. Please have the complete picture of this diagram on your mind. So in our future classes, we are going to discuss the total discussions of the concepts will happen based upon this design. So please try to have the image of this diagram in your mind. So, or if not, please have the photocopy of this diagram in your hand. Okay. So, hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.